country. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Honourable Member.
Honourable Chairperson, if you want to change the Constitution or an entrenched section of the Constitution or the Bill of Rights, you cannot make a single procedural error, not one. In this process, many errors were made and are still being made. The Freedom Front Plus reserves all its rights with regard to this process, and the making of recommendations under these circumstances should not be construed under any circumstances as approval or consent of the errors and procedure which have been willfully committed by the committee and some of its members, even after they were warned on more than one occasion. We believe that the current process is fundamentally flawed. We believe that the majority of the committee seems to be willing to take a report to Parliament that will embarrass Parliament and the President. However, we think that the whole process was flawed. I would first like to react to the process itself and how that process went along. We remember that the President, and I'll come back to that. Let's start with the process and the public hearings in the beginning. We know that there were 33 meetings held across South Africa in all nine provinces, and it's common cause that approximately on average 75 people spoke at each meeting. Let's say for argument's sake that the majority of them were in favor of amending the Constitution, which is not the case, but the majority were, we accept that. Let's say that 1,000 people attended those meetings, and all of them were in favor of amending the Constitution. We're talking about 33,000 people in that instance. Then we come to the written submissions. On 14 March 2018, the President, during question time, called on the public to make submissions. He was going on in the House, like in the constitutional process, we need submissions. And the public listened. On 31st of May, this ad was placed in the media, inviting the public to make submissions, and they listened. 24 June, the spokesperson, Moloto Motapo of Parliament, said to African News Agency the following: the Constitutional Review Committee is in the process of contracting a service provider to increase the capacity of the CRC with the aim to analyze the submissions to ensure that each and every submission would be considered. Even submissions with only a name, cell phone number, or email address shall be considered. Actual process, it didn't happen, and we know it didn't happen. Not one single written submission was addressed to any political party or to any member of this committee. They were addressed to Parliament. Later on, it was said that members could go and have a look, which they did. But Parliament failed in its role and the committee in that sense. Until today, no report that deals with the written submissions were presented to the committee. More than 200,000 emails are somewhere in cyberspace and were never made available to members of the committee. No report that deals with the written submissions were ever adopted or even discussed by the committee. If we take the statistics given by that service provider, it's clear that 630,000 written submissions were allegedly received. 472,344 said no to the change of the Constitution. That's 74.9%. 153,000 said yes to the Constitution's change. That's 24%. A majority of 75% were against that. Then we come to the oral submissions and hearings we had here over 6 days. In total, approximately 53 people came, and that's part of the submission and the resolution that we adopted in Parliament that said we should also engage with civil society, academics, organs of society, business, etc. 53 organizations came. In my submission, page 4 and 5, I present you with a list, each and every one. Some of us attended all of those. Some of us attended all of those. Of those oral submissions, 41 out of 53 of them said no to the amendment of Constitution. That's 77.3%. 11 said yes. That's 20%. Once again, more than 75% of the people that came here to make an oral submission said, no, don't change the Constitution. However, it seems that we are convinced, some of us, that the Constitution should be changed under all circumstances. We've got a choice. If we seriously want to address the land issue, which I believe we should do it in a proper fashion. If we want to play politics with the election in mind, we can force this process through Parliament, and we will have to pay the consequences in the end. That's your decision. Those who have got the majority in this committee, they must take that decision. We were told by many people in terms of the implications, in terms of international treaties. Go and have a look at Section 17 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. Go and look at the AGOA Act that will impact on our economy. But we can ignore that. Let me then come in conclusion, Chairperson. The written submissions, as well as the oral submissions, make it abundantly clear with a 75%+ majority in front of this commission that there were no grounds whatsoever to argue that the evidence put in front of the committee now, up to this point, necessitates an amendment of the Constitution of South Africa. On the contrary, they said exactly the opposite. Chairpersons told us throughout, the submissions are just as important as the oral hearings outside. I accept that, but look at the figures involved. If the ANC, with the support of some other parties, goes ahead and recommend to Parliament that Section 25 of the Constitution should be changed, it can only be argued on the basis of the pronouncement by President Ramaphosa already on the 31st of July, when he said, quote, accordingly, the ANC will, through parliamentary process, finalize a proposed amendment to the Constitution that outlines more clearly the conditions under which appropriation of land without compensation can be effected. A factual statement, it will do so. That happened in the middle of this process. We were still busy with provincial hearings. At that stage, we haven't heard one oral submission by people that we invited to come here. We've not received any report, but it was announced already at that stage. The South African public and international community should take note that the protest, this whole process, as far as we are concerned, was a charade and therefore fundamentally flawed. The decision to amend Section 25 was taken by the NEC of the ANC and announced by President Ramaphosa already on the 31st of July. We wasted the time and money of thousands of people out there. With regard to recommendations in conclusion, if we want to address the problem, and nobody came in this process and said, we do not accept that we have an urgent challenge in terms of land. However, the fingers pointed at the government for failing in the last 24 years. Now the Constitution is blamed. Recommendations, if you are serious, we call for a proper land audit to provide clarity on land reform in South Africa and to formulate a clear strategy for land redistribution plan. We say that the state must make available the 4,000 farms already bought.
Please conclude.
And we've got my submissions and recommendations are in this document of 15 pages. I'm constricted to a few minutes. In conclusion, we are of the view that the Constitution should not be blamed and therefore if expropriation without compensation is not the answer, Section 25 is not the problem, and it should not be amended.
Thank you very much, Honourable Mulder.